or leave in the morning.
You're listening to Music and Anime, Parch Radio, 69.nice. We've got the 5 anime love songs for your heartstrings. So let's get into it. I mean, into it with number 5.
Welcome to Music and Anime. My name is Ab. I really hope you enjoyed that intro as much as I enjoyed making it. Number 5 on the list, and this isn't in any particular order, it's just a list of 5 songs I put together. It's And It's So Beautiful by James Shimoji. It's featuring Kitty Brown, and this is off of the movie Redline. The movie soundtrack is best known for the kind of hip-hop, breakbeat, funky tunes, and high-octane tracks, but this movie's got some romance in it and some tracks to back it up, this one being one of them. We're in your 90s. Slow jam territory with this one. You know, we're talking. And of course, because things are going so well. Number 4 is a very recent ad, and that is Falling Starlight and Moonlight from Metallic Rouge. It's an anime that's currently airing as I'm recording this. If you're looking for something with a cyber futuristic setting, societal issues, awesome robot fights, and a barking protagonist, then yeah, it's definitely worth a watch so far. Again, it's only a few episodes in. Let me know in the comments if you're watching it too, but Taisei Iwasaki is one of the composers who worked on the music for this series. But this song, Falling Starlight and Moonlight, has a couple of different versions in the soundtrack. The one that plays in the first episode is version 2 of the song, and it feels kind of like I Really Want to Stay at Your House, if you know that from Cyberpunk, which I'm sure you know that from Edgerunners and everything. But I would say if you like that song, give this one a listen. If you want something that feels a little more classic, you know, a little more mid-century pop. The very first track in Metallic Rouge's soundtrack is the first version of the song, which definitely has more of that classic feel. I also did a cover based on that version on my secondary channel. I'll drop that in the description if you wanted to check that out.
When I saw you, I loved you from the start.
Number 3 on the list, we have Koi no Uta by Dynamite Beans. This is from Tamako Love Story, and I think this song beautifully captures the young love story that this is. And no matter where you are in your life, no matter how old or young you are, those feelings you have for someone, those insecurities you have with yourself in those early stages of it all, caring for someone and loving someone from afar and wanting to say something, but of course it's embarrassing if you do, criticizing yourself after every interaction with them, and just all of that. But the lyrics in this song, a lot of Tamako Love Story is that almost saying, almost doing, and that wanting to but holding yourself back. I think the chorus says it beautifully. It says, however, as I do not have the courage to do more than that, at least I will sing this song for you alone. And there's just something super relatable to that, super like, I absolutely love this song for that. The song is super catchy as well. I love everything about it. The series is animated by Kyoto Animation, so it looks beautiful as well. But the soundtrack and a couple of the songs, including this one, have been pressed on vinyl, and I'm hoping they make it to my collection someday. But that is number 3, Koi no Uta by the Dynamite Beans. Number 2 on the list here, and one that was so real to me at a time, and so it has that just attachment, you know, for me. This is One More Time, One More Chance by Masayoshi Yamazaki. This is from 5 centimeters per second. This is a Makoto Shinkai film, and one of my favorite one of his. This movie is about what if I stayed? What if I chose a different path that kept me closer? Did this instead of that? Would we have had a life together? Would we have actually been happier? Would we have a beautiful life together? Because you get the gist that these are two people that do feel for each other, do care for each other in a way that could be more, but because the way their paths divert, it's about those, what if I acted on this? What if I did that? 5 centimeters per second does that in such a beautiful way. And this song, it could be a little sad, but I love how it perfectly encapsulates that feeling that very real thing and a very specific kind of thing that, you know, people do go through and, you know, I went through. And, you know, love is a perfect gift that isn't always perfectly wrapped and exchanged, and that's okay. This song being as beautiful and calming and relaxing as it is and everything helps cope with those kind of, you know, feelings and stuff as well. So, yeah.
I'm editing the video and went on PlayAsia's website to get some images and the links to Tomoko Love Story, because I know that those were pressed on vinyl and, you know, I had mentioned them. But as I'm here, I'm scrolling through to go to the other ones and everything, and on their Others Also Bought section, I'm scrolling and just looking at stuff, and I see that One More Time, One More Chance is there. I'm thinking, oh, that's gotta be a CD or something like that, but then the price, I'm like, that's pretty expensive for a CD or something like that. I click on it, and it's on vinyl as well. I did not make this list based off of what was available on vinyl or anything, but this one just so happens to be, and there are a lot of records that came out last year. I want to talk about that at some point, but yeah, still very expensive for a single, but that also exists, and I'm also shocked by that. So yeah, there's that. Anyway, on with the video.
Before going on to number one on the list, just comment down below any of your, I know there's a ton of love songs, romance songs, anything in an anime and stuff like that, which there are a lot of you out there who I know have their favorite love song and stuff from any romance series or anything like that. So just comment those below to help me make a bigger list for the next time. On to number one. I am a fan of Beck Mongolian Chop Squad. This is a series I've seen years ago, and I've only ever seen it when I was a kid. And I haven't seen it now that I'm older, and I really want to go back to the series and watch it. But one thing that has always stuck with me is Moon on the Water. Moon on the Water is also known as Full Moon Sway, but the song is about a very complicated situation. It's about being in a relationship that you could see ending, but still choosing to remain in it, whether it be because you can't bring yourself to end it, or I don't know what tomorrow brings. Maybe things do get better, except you're not really thinking that, because you might also be developing feelings for a friend that you have that's also near and dear to you. So do you choose to end a relationship you're in that may get better, and for a relationship that might not even happen? Or again, it's a very complicated situation. You're not a bad person, you're human. Like, you develop feelings, and why are you feeling that way? It's because maybe certain things are lacking here and there, and it's about all sorts of complex things and stuff like that. And this song pieces that together in a way that's, again, just very relatable. I mean, you call yourself a fool because what do you do? How should you act? What is the right thing to do? We're only human, and we're terrified of making mistakes. We're terrified of making the wrong choice and just not knowing what the wrong choice even is. Again, it's very, very difficult. It's a song that already hits as is if you've never been in that kind of situation or anything. I mean, the way the song sounds, it's a great song. But yeah, if you've ever lived that very complicated situation, again, even though it's on the not okay side of things, whether it's dying somewhere and blooming somewhere else, it's a love song nonetheless, and this one's for all the sad homies out there.
I'm a fool, I don't know about tomorrow, what it's like to be, oh. I'm a fool, couldn't let myself go, even though I feel the end.
Keep on listening to music that make these love songs and anime so great. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.